Welcome, friends. Pull up a chair and pour yourselves a cup of your favorite brew, because we're about to dive into the swirling world of royal drama, the kind that could make a grown prince consider packing up his sunscreen and heading back to jolly old England. Picture this. Harry and Meghan, the royal rebel duo, are having a bit of a panic. They're feeling the money crunch, and boy, is it a squeeze. There's chatter in the grapevine that Harry may be close to swallowing that princely pride of his and returning to his family. And we're not talking about a Thanksgiving dinner. You see, their $2 billion Spotify dream turned out to be a bit more of a, well, nightmare. That's not doing any favors for the couple who traded in their royal teacups for Hollywood sunglasses and dreams of green. And by green, I mean dollars. Did we mention that they also wanted to raise their children in the land of the free? But it appears that their Hollywood dream could cost them more than they bargained for. They're looking at possibly losing more than half of their $100 million salary from Netflix. Yes, that's right. Netflix is also in the picture. The streaming giant wants to release not one, but two productions made by the couple. Their docuseries, creatively named Harry and Meghan, has been under a lot of scrutinies. And guess what? The Netflix deal ends at 8:25 p.m., and the whole thing, well, it's been quite the roller coaster. Not the fun kind, mind you. They're also stuck with an annual security bill that's the price of a swanky mansion in Montecito, a whopping $18 million. The chatter from insiders is that to save themselves from this financial quagmire, Harry and Meghan may have to consider a homecoming to the royal roost. A step back into the gilded cage would definitely ease their financial woes, as one mansion expert whispered to the National Enquirer magazine. However, making peace with King Charles might not be a walk in the park. Meghan would likely go to any lengths to avoid the embarrassment of having to downsize their mansion. And Spotify dropping them didn't just bruise their egos, it was a financial gut punch too. Remember when Bill Simmons, that big-shot Spotify executive, labeled them as grifters? Then, when the Hollywood agent ran out of talents, Meghan felt the sting even more. The Spotify deal took a massive hit when Taylor Swift turned down Meghan's invitation to appear on Archwell, and Harry's offer to interview high-profile personalities like Donald Trump and the Pope was met with ridicule. One thing is for sure, the Sussexes are not in the most enviable position. Many believe they have little to offer beyond their royal connections, a route which they've overplayed, resulting in being branded as a one-trick pony and a Hollywood flop. Rumors are even swirling about a potential deal with Saudi Arabia's controversial public investment fund. The big question that keeps popping up is, how far are they willing to go to cling onto their newfound lives? And on that cliffhanger, we will leave you hanging for a bit. Well, folks, grab your popcorn because we're about to delve into a bit of a Hollywood whodunit that involves our very own Meghan. And it's every bit as complicated as you'd expect it to be. Ever heard of the talent agency W? Meghan recently inked a deal with them. The question on everyone's lips, though, is whether she had to pony up a cool $1 million for the privilege, or if they rolled out the red carpet for her free of charge. And oh boy, does this story get juicy. There's talk of some serious, scandalous action behind the scenes, involving blackmail no less. Now keep this on the down low, but rumor has it the CEO sealed the deal with W using some pretty shady tactics. If that doesn't pique your interest, then get a load of this. The CEO, Mr. Emanuel, was reportedly linked to a certain Epstein. You might know the name. And not in a way that anyone would want to be. There was a lawsuit back in April 2002, filed by agent Sandra Epstein against the Endeavor agency, which brought up a whole dirty laundry list of accusations against Emanuel. Court documents suggest Emanuel allowed a friend to operate an adult-themed website from the Endeavor offices. Now, if that's not scandalous enough, Epstein also claimed Emanuel made some pretty outrageous racial and homophobic remarks. One alleged example: he put the brakes on a script about Navy SEALs intended for actor Wesley Snipes with a comment that could curdle milk. Emanuel contested these allegations, of course, and the claims totaled a neat sum of $25 million. I wish I could say I'm surprised, but let's face it, Hollywood has always been a bit of a Wild West show. What's more intriguing, though, is the minority media advocacy group, which Meghan is a part of. They seem to be turning a blind eye to Emanuel's actions without much proof to support their stance. I mean, the cynic in me does wonder if Megan is greasing some palms to keep the good press rolling in. If not, she's certainly knee-deep in the same messy industry. It seems like our dear Hollywood operates more like a mafia syndicate these days. I would take an honest, hard-working American any day over these rich bigwigs with their dubious dealings. Could this be the real reason Megan's been hiding and fussing over security lately? Are the skeletons in the closet starting to rattle a little too loudly? Now, if we delve into the murky past, it starts to seem that when Harry prattles on about Megan's safety, he might not be talking about her physical well-being after all. Imagine for a moment if they've received death threats from the shadiest of underworld figures. The Sussex duo wouldn't exactly hold a press conference to spill those beans. They'd likely continue playing their own tune, blaming it all on good old-fashioned racism. Consider this. The former Chicago mayor, chummy with the Democrats, could have been entwined with Megan when she was still linked to Epstein, or perhaps during her college years, when she might have been seeing clients at a suburban strip club. Just imagine if she had started keeping a record of these encounters early on, with dreams of a future political run in her head. Given the precarious tightrope Megan seems to be walking, it's a wonder she's still playing the game. Unless, of course, her potential blackmail material makes her an indispensable cog in this web of deceit. It's no secret Harry harps on about Megan's safety. If they were under threat from gangsters, they certainly wouldn't publicize it. But there's more to this story. Let's not forget, Megan's talent, or rather lack thereof, isn't opening any Hollywood doors for her. It's not just about the dearth of talent. There's a growing awareness of the kind of person she is, and it seems like everyone's starting to give her a wide berth. Now, I bet the claws come out when divorce settlements are brought up, but those waters are still uncharted. And you know, there's gotta be a tale about Megan and her mother that dates back to when Doria was in the maternity ward. They must have all the nitty-gritty details, right down to the number of stitches after the C-section and the exact moment Meghan Markle took her first breath. Megan's in for a real wake-up call. Her ultimate goal seems to be as far from her reality as possible. She's knocking on Hollywood's back door after her dismal stint as an actress, holding on to those receipts she's collected over the years. She believes these can open doors for her, even the one to the Oval Office. After all, if Trump could do it, why not Megan? As we navigate this wild roller coaster ride, Megan might find herself out of the limelight if she continues on this path. It's likely she's in for a monumental surprise, and let's be real here, it won't be the good kind. There's always been this nagging thought at the back of my mind. Is Megan just a smokescreen for something, or someone else? Sounds far-fetched, you say? But think about it. She's been coated in Teflon, with scandal after scandal sliding off her without a trace. It's downright bizarre how she's managed to dodge the fallout of her actions. And that leaves me scratching my head, folks. Recall how Megan declared in an interview once that she harbored ambitions of diving into the political arena even before she got a taste of the movie industry, courtesy of her dad's job as a lighting director in Hollywood. However, it's unlikely she considered her past could pose a threat to her safety back then. But now? That seems all too plausible. I remember thinking years ago when Megan first began sporting that baby bump, and the royals seemed to play along with the charade, that maybe blackmail was at play. As for the industry's questionable behavior, it's so commonplace that repercussions rarely enter the picture. The moneyed elite at the helm don't think twice about shelling out big bucks or dishing out plum rolls to their minions before discarding them. Remember the old Hollywood stars? Some had their initial, shall we say, more risque films held over their heads by studios to keep them on a tight leash. Marilyn Monroe's story comes to mind here, which often found its way onto the silver screen under the guise of teen movies. But hey, that's just me musing out loud. What do you all think? Feel free to drop a comment below. If you found this video insightful, consider hitting the like button and sharing it with your friends and family. Thanks for tuning in, have a great week, and I'll catch you in the next video.